As of this update, there's been a lot of research done thanks to military medicine about hemostatic agents. They come in a different form than we might see out here where it's in bulk in the military setting, and we might see it integrated into even something as little as a 1x1 gauze bandage. In this case, the actual hemostatic agent has been impregnated into the bandage itself, and it's meant for just small venous bleeds and capillary bleeds. But in arterial bleeds or in abdominal explosive types of accidents, we see it come in packets as a powder, and it can be basically opened and poured into the hard to control bleeding abdomen or wound and helps to coagulate that bleeding so it will clot that off and give us some time until we get them into a surgical center where it can be controlled through surgery and repair. It's something we need to be aware of. It does come in the two different forms, powder and impregnated in the actual bandages themselves. And it is meant to be used when normal bleeding control methods are not being as effective, or when we see delayed response from emergency medicine, or we may be in far off and distant areas, wilderness medicine, forestry, mining, and we have a delay of extrication of the victim. So just something we need to be aware of now in this update training, that hemostatic agents are available and they're commercially available for use when we're maybe having difficulty controlling bleeding in the normal traditional methods.